Ladies and gentlemen, шановні пані і панове, щоб провадити різними нашими працями, акціями і так далі, потрібно сильну надбудову. Вона знаходиться під Конгресом українців Канади, і нема кращого правника, як наш президент Павло Грод, якого я прошу тепло привітати.
Христос хрестився! Dear fellow Canadians, dear friends from Ukraine, we're asked very often, why are we gathered here today? We are gathered here today to show support to our brethren in Ukraine who are standing up for Ukrainian democracy and saying no to a police state which this president is trying to introduce. Over the last 72 hours, the Parliament of Ukraine has introduced sweeping legislation which creates a very, very tense situation. Ukraine today is on the brink of civil war. War with the government. This government has no interest in civil discourse, has no interest in hearing the words of the people. And this government is trying to introduce a Lukashenko, Putin style of government in order to stay in power. We as the Ukrainian Canadian community, we as Canadians have a very, very important role to play. First of all, we cannot give up hope. We must continue to support the people of Ukraine. We are supporting the people of Ukraine on numerous fronts. First of all, this rally and rallies are happening across the country and are happening across the world. We are coordinating this through the Ukrainian Canadian Congress and the Ukrainian World Congress in order to ensure that pressure stays on and the people of Ukraine know that they're not alone. Number two, we're supporting them by raising funds and ensuring that we're providing them with the necessary support that the people in Ukraine need. Number three, what's very important for all of us today to walk away from this rally and understand that it's all of our responsibility to ensure that the world does not forget about Ukraine. We cannot afford Ukraine fatigue. The world needs to make sure that Ukraine does not become another Belarus or another Russia. We need to keep the focus. We need to make sure that the media is paying attention to what's happening in Ukraine, that our politicians are keeping track of what's happening in Ukraine to ensure that, God forbid, there is any crackdown, that we stand up for the people of Ukraine. We need to ensure that when you go back home, that you are contacting your members of parliament, you are contacting the media and asking them to make sure that they're covering the situation in Ukraine. We need to ensure that we continue to be vigilant. But it's also a longer-term game. There's no magic bullet. We have to ensure that we continue to support Ukraine's democracy. How? Support those organizations in Ukraine that stand up for civil society. We have to be prepared for elections that are happening in 2015. The Ukrainian-Canadian community, all of you, have played a very important role in trying to protect democracy in Ukraine. These presidential elections are going to be happening in a year's time. February 2015 are going to be critical for Ukraine's future. And that's why I call all of you, when you're booking your vacation, make sure that you are available to go to Ukraine en masse in February of 2015, because that is what you can do to support Ukraine's democracy. Разом ми будемо стоювати разом до кінця. Слава Україні!
Героям слава!